हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम श्वेता याग्निक, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट कंप्यूटर इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एट एलजे इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। दिस वीडियो सीरीज इज फॉर द सब्जेक्ट पाइथन प्रोग्रामिंग विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू द कोर्स डिजाइंड बाय गुजरात टेक्नोलॉजिकल यूनिवर्सिटी। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द एजेंडा। द टॉपिक्स टू बी कवर्ड विद इन दिस वीडियो इज व्हाट इज पाइथन, why python is being used, features of python, basic elements of python, releases of python, python code execution, and lastly we are going to see a sample program and its execution. So let's begin with what is python. It is a general purpose programming language which is conceived in 1989 by a Dutch programmer Guido van Rossum. Okay, the reason for its fastest growing is depend on the developers and companies who are using it. Okay, the active and supportive community makes the development approach very easy. Secondly, the freely available libraries that provide useful extended functionalities. The libraries like tkinter, used to create GUI application, turtle to draw different shapes on virtual canvas, the shapes like rectangle, square, triangle and many more complex shapes. Okay, for that we use turtle, numpy for numerical computation, scipy for mathematical operation, pandas for large data handling. So these are the some of the libraries which makes the use of python very powerful. Next, why python, or the areas where it is used, are data processing, software and web development, games, scientific computing, machine learning, implementing AI algorithms like artificial neural network and convolutional neural network, GUI application. Suppose if I want to develop a GUI application where I want to have a GUI layout like text areas, buttons, radio, text areas, etc., then I'll be using tkinter library in order to develop all these GUI layouts. So that's why Python is really important in GUI development as well. The commercial usage, different companies and communities uses Python. Okay, the Google uses Python in its web search engine. YouTube uses Python for its service of video sharing, and Cisco, Intel, IBM, etc. uses Python in order for their hardware testing purposes. So these are real revenue generating applications of Python. That is why Python is being used by so many companies. The list is here, you can see it. Due to its vast commercial usage, academic usage is also widely spread, and schools and colleges have incorporated this subject. It is open source, that is also one of the advantage. It is freely available source code. As per the requirement, it can be modified, and support to different platform is provided through Python Software Foundation, that is www.python.org. The features of Python, that is simple and easy to learn. It is having simple structure, so developer friendly programming language, we can say that. An advancement of machine learning and AI, where research scientists cannot afford time to learn a specific programming language. So they went for the easiest programming language, and Python is their choice. The source can be compiled or just run in time. So Python is compiled as well as interpreted language. So let us understand the difference. Interpreter translates the program one statement at a time, that means step by step execution, while compiler translates the whole program. Interpreter overall execution time is slower, while compiler's overall execution time is faster because it analyzes the whole source code at one go. No intermediate code is generated in case of interpreter, while in case of compiler, intermediate code is generated. okay? Like in Java, it generates bytecode. Similarly, in case of Python, it generates bytecode. So compiler produces intermediate code. Interpreter continues translating program until the first error is met. So debugging is really easy. Programmer will come to know where exactly the error is found in case of interpreter, while in compiler, where the whole program is compiled together and result is displayed after the end of the program. That is the reason it is really very difficult for the programmer to locate the error. Fine. So the Python, Ruby, etc. using interpreter, C compiler. Next, features of Python. It is dynamically typed. That means the object and its type are determined at runtime, not at compile time. Assignment statement binds the name to an object at the type at runtime, not at compile time, and it may later be changed. It is platform independent, that means portable. Python program, when it is given to Python compiler, it generates bytecode. Using Python Python virtual machine, anybody can run bytecode instruction on the platform. That means it is platform independent. It supports the platform like Windows, Linux, Unix and Macintosh. It is widely used and because of its extensive capabilities and documentation and support, and access to advanced maths, statistics and database functionality are the critical features of Python. It is multi-paradigm language. The style of binding structure and elements of the computer programs can be either procedural oriented or object oriented. So one can use the Python in order to develop its program in procedural oriented way, or the programmer may choose to implement its functionality using object oriented method. Okay, Python supports both way. So we can create, use routines and subroutine, that is set of modules that can be used in our program to support rapid application development, and it also supports the object oriented way. Compulsory indentation is required. Python doesn't use curly brackets, but it uses indentation to form a block. Data manipulation is quite easy because Python uses list, tuples, string, and the use of associative array that because of that the manipulation becomes really easy. Next, basic elements of Python. They are script. Python program, also called script, is a sequence of commands to perform a defined task. Shell executes a single Python command and get the result. This is the picture which shows the shell. Okay, so if you are having installed version of Python, here I have installed 2.7 version, and using Python shell I can get this window. Using Windows command prompt you can get to the Python. Okay, at the end when we are going to explore the sample program, we will see how to go to Python command prompt using Windows, right? So till then we'll go further. Statement, a command instructs interpreter to do something. Here the statement is 3 plus 4, that is instruction to perform addition between these two numbers, and the answer is 7. Object, a core thing that Python program manipulates. Every object has a type that defines the kind of thing that programs can do. Next, types of object are scalar, that is atomic or indivisible. The types of scalar objects are integer, float, boolean, that is either true or false. None is something new in Python that is used to signal empty or null. That means, for example, if a function exits without return being executed, then function will return none. Non-scalar objects, it has an internal structure. It is composed of scalar as well as non-scalar values. The examples of non-scalar objects are list, tuples, string. We can extract parts of non-scalar objects using either index or using some other operations. We will see it later on. Next, basic elements of Python. Variables, the way it is a way to associate names with an object. Here we are having one example, radius. Radius is a variable, and 11 is the value associated with that variable radius. So there are some rules to define a name for a variable. The first rule is it must start with a letter and can contain letters, digit and underscore. But the rule is it must start with a letter. Secondly, it is case sensitive, means capital X and small x are defining different variable. Keywords like if, else, elif are not allowed because they are predefined keywords. So they cannot be used as a variable name. Python allows multiple assignment. So here, as it is written, x, y and z equal to 3, 4, 5. That means here 3 is associated with x, 4 is associated with y, and z is associated with 5. Z is initialized with 5. So within single line you can bind the values to respective variables. Next, comments. So Python use hash symbol in order to have a comment. Okay, comment is not interpreted by interpreter. The triple quote means only for documentation text. So for general purpose in programs, we'll be using hash in order to comment specific line. Release of Python. Python 1.0 released in 1994, Python 2.0 released in 2000, and the latest version is 2.7. Python 3.0 released in 2008, and the latest release is 3.8. In this course, we are going to deal with Python 2.0 version, and we'll be using 2.7 specifically. Installing a Python, you will get the Python for your platform from this website python.org downloads. Here you can see Python is providing support for many platforms like Linux, Unix, Windows, Macintosh and etc. So you can visit this site in order to get the specific version of the Python. Next, Python code execution. As the picture depicts, the source code where our Python program is written, the extension of the source code is .py. Okay, .py is an extension of the Python program. Then it is given to Python interpreter, where it is compiled and bytecode is generated. That means compiler generates intermediate code that we are calling here as a bytecode, and the extension for the bytecode is PYC. Okay, then Python virtual machine interpret it and execute the program finally. This whole process is with respect to interpreter's point of view. Okay, the source code is translated into bytecode, which is then run by PVM. But here comes the beauty of Python. Python programmer's point of view, we don't have to worry about compilation at all. We just need to run that Python file through the interpreter by giving command Python on command prompt. Okay, that's it. We are supposed to do as a programmer. Internal execution of compiler to bytecode and bytecode will be interpreted by PVM. That portion we are not supposed to worry as a programmer. So that is the beauty of Python. So here now we are going to see one sample program where we'll be using editor Notepad++. The aim of the programmer is just to print hello, and name of the program will be hello.py. Remember that the name of the Python program must be .py extension. Okay, so let's start with Notepad++. Here I'll be writing a comment hash example to print hello okay. And here I'll be using print function, and within single quote I can write hello students. Okay, I will write the string in single quote, or I can write it in double quotes. Okay, I will save now this file at specific location, and name of the file is hello.py. okay, and save it. Now I will try to execute it. So this is the command line. First of all, I will clear it, then write Python. Just write Python and enter. So this is the command prompt, Python command prompt. You can see it here, Python command prompt. Okay, and the version of the Python is 2.7.18. okay, and this is the command prompt, Python command prompt. If you want to get out of it, you can write Control Z. So this is the Windows command prompt. Okay, from here I'll be writing Python. This is command to interpreter to execute my program, and name of my program is hello.py. and here I am in the same directory where I have stored my program, so that I don't need to worry about the location of hello.py, right? So I am here at the location where hello.py is already stored, right? So as soon as I print enter, it will print hello students. Okay, this line is because of this code which you have written here. Okay, hello students. Now if I want to change here a little bit, hello students, and instead of single I will be using double quotes at both the ends, hello students, how are you. Okay, again save the program. Here asterisk symbol, you can see that means the file is not yet saved. So just save it one more time, and again try to execute it using Python space hello.py. okay, so with the changed effect the output is displayed. So I hope you got the clarity about how you can execute the Python, simple Python program. Okay, so that's it for this video. Thank you for watching, and if you are having any doubt, you can contact me or write in comment section.